All right, welcome back, guys. I hope everyone is doing fine in the lockdown, and I have some exciting news. As you've probably seen from the title and probably from the thumbnail, I bought myself a lathe. Yeah, why, you may ask? Well, I like to do everything myself, as you probably noticed, like I did with my engine mounts, and obviously things can be bought, and but I like learning new things and developing my skills. Obviously, it wasn't the cheapest thing, but I wanted to buy something of good quality. So there is a really nice Facebook group, UK welding and fabricators enthusiasts, something like that. So I asked that question over there, because there's quite a few Chinese makes of lathes, mini lathes, on eBay and Amazon and some other websites. And a lot of people were just saying, literally, just go for one of these, Warco, or just a hobby. Just a hobby or just a student or something like that. So I've got myself a Warco WM 180. So let's have a look what's inside. Are you fed up with that Corona stuff as much as everyone else? I bet you are. Hey, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click that like button as well. Here's the machine. It's actually quite small. I am extremely surprised at how small this thing is. I mean, I've seen it in the description, obviously, when I was buying it, that there was supposed to be 813 mil, which is, obviously, height is 30 something, and width almost irrelevant, but yeah, it's about 38, 40, depending on how far this thing moves. This is going to be a very interesting review unboxing, because I know nothing about lathes. I mean, I know a few things. I've watched some videos and I've done my research, but I would not be able to tell you anything super exciting in a sense like, oh, look at this new feature, whatever, because I don't really know many features. All of it is really new to me. I just want to learn, I want to try, and I have a few little parts I need to make. And obviously, you can find somebody who can make it for you, but why pay somebody to do it if you can do it yourself? And obviously, like I said, develop new skills and stuff like that. So, very quickly, for those of you who don't own a lathe or know nothing about the lathe, it's like I said before, it's WM 180. It has a 600 or 650 watt motor, which is fairly powerful. It comes standard with quite a few accessories and bits and pieces. I'll show you what it comes with afterwards, but that's the machine, how it came in a box. It weighs 70 kilos, and which is not as it's actually not as heavy as I thought. I thought 70 kilos would be like, wow, you can't really lift it, but I asked the delivery guy to help me out, and it was actually fairly easy to put it on. I still need to attach this tray that goes underneath, and then we need to put all the spindles on. We need to plug it in. We need to take a few bits that they actually attached for transportation, so it doesn't, and then put another drill chuck on there, and yeah, I'm gonna clap and it's gonna happen. Ba-bam! Kind of all assembled. I mean, there is not that much to assemble. So quick run through. This thing moves left and right. This is your lock unlock. This thing locks or unlocks the movement of this. I'm not even gonna pretend or say very fancy names. Let's pretend this is aimed at people who know nothing about lathe, and they're just like, oh cool, what a nice little toy, you know, look how shiny it is. Those are the people I'm aiming this for, this video. Not the people who know things and stuff. That's why I'm just calling it this thing. This is your protective hood. For obvious reasons, safety first. I actually seen some people take them off. I don't think it's such a good idea. This is your chuck assembly. Obviously, the motor is inside. This spindle is your horizontal movement, so to speak. This one is your, actually, if we do X, Y, Z axis, yeah, so this is X, this would be your Y, going back and forth like that, and this is your X, but very fine, very, very slow and precise. Obviously, all of the spindles have dials on them, and so you know how far it went. This thing locks to your shaft for thread cutting, or whenever you're doing passes and stuff like that. Obviously, if you have a long blank in there, and you, let's say you want to take a first pass, let's say just take the top layer off, make it all nice and shiny, get to your diameter. Obviously, you don't start from one corner and then manually go to the left. I mean, obviously you can do it, but it's all done automatically. Once you lock it, it locks to this thread, and then I'll show you once I turn this on. And this is your tool holder. As far as I know, this thing can hold up to 4 tools. Yeah, because you can sort of stack them like that, and then it's almost like a quick swap. I already put one tool. I actually only have 2 tools. I ordered the whole packet. There's like a 38 bits and pieces, but it hasn't arrived. I need to email them, give them a call tomorrow. So I can't even do any tests for you today. All I have is a thread cutting tool. And anyways, so yeah, you just basically rotate. You can have one for radius cut, for flat cut, or whatever. I don't even know all those names. And what else? That's your speed dial. There's 2 settings. Obviously, there's a sprockets in there. I'll show you in a minute. And you can put either have A or B. On A, it goes from 50 to 1250 RPM. And in B mode, it goes from 100 to 2,500 RPM. Right now, it's set at A, which is 50 to 1,250. And those are all your charts for thread cutting and whatnot. This is your forward or reverse. Obviously, the motor can go either way. That's your emergency stop. I think it's very important. And those are your buttons. So let's have a look. Put it in forward. Close the thing. Obviously, we don't have anything in there. Press start. Would be good if I actually turned it on. Yeah. That's at your 80 revolutions per second. As soon as you open it, boom. Safety first, guys. And that's your 1200. As you can see, the shaft is rotating. I'm not sure if you can actually engage it while it's rotating. Let's test. Yeah, you can. So you see how this thing is starting to move? So obviously, it would automatically cut a pass. So once you've done with that, what you can do, you can disengage, go back, and then you go a bit more in, engage, and you have another pass. Brilliant. Obviously, it comes with a handbook. I think I'm actually going to read it for once. This is very interesting. Yep, that's the box of tools that it comes with. Let's have a look what we have in here. That's what they call an arbor. Arbor? It's all very new to me, but that thing essentially goes on the side of your lathe, and that's what holds this bit of metal on that side. Those are some spare parts, replacement little blades for indexable tools I bought. A set of sprockets, because obviously you can do threading and all that stuff, so they give you all sorts of different variations. It can cut from 0.3 all the way to 3. That's a pitch of your bolt. You know how M8 is 1.25 or M10 is 1.5. So yeah, you can cut all the way from 0.3, which is tiny. I believe it's like M1 or something like that, all the way to like coarse thread of 3. We have a chucky chuck. That one is spring loaded. That goes in here. And the reason why it's spring loaded, so you never forget it inside, because obviously you don't want to start this machine with this thing on, so it will always jump off. Some people say they're really, really annoying, so they either buy one that is not spring loaded or modify this one. Set of spanners, 12, 14, 10 and 8. Those are some handles. I've seen a lot of YouTube videos where people make their own, and to be honest with you, that's not a bad shout, because I mean, obviously those things are more than usable, clearly, but I can practice. I can buy some brass or aluminium and make them a little bit longer, a little bit thicker, with, you know, some cool lines. So that could be one of my first projects. Another key. So we have two screwdrivers. Those are jaws for the holding chuck thingy bob. I'm not sure how they're different to the one that is already installed in there. Some Allen keys. That's a oil squirter thingy. Okay, oh yeah, so that goes on there. And another big Allen key. Huh, strange. Is the same size, so I guess you'll probably need two at some point. And this sprocket, 42 it says. Ah, that's different, because that one is a fine tooth, so that's probably a spare part for thread cutting thread. This one, that's when you're cutting the thread, the whole machine sort of follows it, and you cut it and you set the speed in there, and there is a little sprocket in there. That's what basically fixes it to the machine itself. Let's have a look what we have in here. Uh-huh. No idea. I have no idea. Well, 3 bolts. So that clearly attaches to something. Duh, Captain Obvious. I'm gonna have to look at the instruction manual, so. This is something extra I bought. This is called a revolving center. Ah, I have a knife there. Why am I ripping it apart? Yep. All covered in oil, which is good. So that's a revolving center. It's the same thing as this one I showed you, but this thing rotates. So when you put your metal, put your thing in there, and you have your bar or something, whatever is spinning, it's not going to be creating friction and heat. This thing will spin with your apparatus, machinos, whatever you're doing. So, like I said, I've done a little bit of research, and that's what sort of people recommend to get straight away as an extra. Unfortunately, okay, so that's MT2, MT3. I have no idea. They have different sizes. I assume they're just different thickness. I thought that thing only took MT2. Which is this, that comes with a kit actually, but I don't know. That's another thing I bought. Interestingly, I am missing something. Those are cutting tools. High speed thread cutting tools. As far as I know, one is, 55 and 60 degrees. This one is for internal threading, and this one is for outside. They obviously go onto your thingy bob, and then your bit of metal, I bought some aluminium actually, rotates, and it scratches, it cuts into the thing at a certain speed, creating a thread. As you can see, high-speed steel. The reason why I got this is, one, I've been recommending them. Because they're cheap, they will last, and they're easy to sharpen, and just, why not? I mean, they're double-ended, so you can do all sorts. So that's that. And then I think this would be quite self-explanatory. Because it says Chuck on the box. Yep. That's a 4-jaw chuck. Don't ask me, I don't know. I have no idea why you need 4. Ah, no, I do. Yeah, that's very good. See, I didn't know shit. So, essentially, that's an independent jaw. So you can position different size, shape bits in there. So for example, hypothetically, if I have a square bar that I need to sort of flatten or whatever, then you can position it like that. So interesting. Let's have a look inside the cover. So that's your gear set. That's from your motor. A small sprocket goes into the big one, then a small one, and that's your spindle. And actually, it's a see-through. So you can see, yeah, so you can actually fit a long bar or whatever, or you can have a manual spindle thing. And those are your thread cutting sprockets. Obviously, you change them according to those instructions, and that will give you your thread cutting depth. Protective switch. As soon as you take this off, obviously the machine will stop. See, it's not even gonna start. Probably would have been a good idea to actually disconnect it, but yeah. this machine is not aimed for your sort of factory size production, paid customers, and you know, like 24 hours running. This is a hobby machine. This is perfect. I mean, size wise, that's tiny. I mean, it is very, very small, because as much as I would like to have a big machine, you've seen my workshop. It's a tiny, small, 3x3 garage, so to speak. And I need a small machine. And obviously, I'm not going to be making really big bits and parts. I mean, it's mostly going to be car related. In fact, this thing, actually, surprisingly, it can handle a really, really a fair size bits. I mean, this thing goes, look, we have 25. If we put a different chuck in there, let's so we have 23 centimeters, which is 9 inches. 9 inches, that's that bit of aluminium obviously can go inside a bit, so fairly long. And as far as I know, you can go up to 100 mil, so that thing. But obviously the motor is not that powerful, so you wouldn't want to run anything bigger than that. So yeah, very exciting. All I need is some tools and start machining bits and pieces. Yeah, there's a few modifications people done to those machines I've seen online. I'll probably do them as well. Like I said, those little handles, I mean, those are nice, but as a practice, why not? I can just buy a brass rod and turn them myself. People change all sorts of things on those. But yeah, thank you very much, guys, for watching. And for those of you who stuck through the whole video, a special thank you. Don't forget to like it if you haven't done so already, but I guess you probably have if you stuck that far back to the end of the video. And yeah, as soon as I get the tools, I will do some test passes and I'll do some test bits and bobs, and yeah, basically gonna play around and make a short video out of that. And hopefully, my famous last words, yeah, hopefully I can make some little parts for the Clio. You'll see what next time. So yeah, until next time, take care. Bye.